Hello and welcome to Trojans Live. Tahj Eaddy is the man certainly responsible for it, the hero of Troy. Some people call it deja vu. Some people call it deja two. A year after Jonah Matthews, number two, knocks out UCLA, Tahj Eaddy does it in almost the exact same fashion. He joins us now, Tahj does, on Trojans Live. Tahj, when it left your hand, how did it feel?
Honestly, it felt really good. It was just kind of my momentum when I was sliding back to the corner, and Ethan got me to pass right on time. So actually, it felt really good leaving my hands.
You went down into your little crouch thing, which I've seen you do a couple times. Was that just because you couldn't see, or were you like, oh, this is going in?
I kind of wanted maybe get the foul if I could, if I did miss it. You know, I was just trying to kind of, I had that going on in my head, but, you know, just thankfully it went in.
Tahj, I meant to ask Coach what he had drawn up on that play. And you know, as a coach, he was going to take he'll take all the praise. Oh yeah, I drew that one up for Tahj. What was that? What was drawn up on the sideline there? Where were you guys running?
Yeah, initially, if you recall the play, I set a screen on Evan's man, and we were trying to get the alley-oop since we were only down two, with a couple of seconds left. So we had a little bit of time, but UCLA did a good job of guarding that initial action. And at that point, it was kind of just a scramble. And fortunately, before we got the 5 second call, I was able to get a little bit of space, and Ethan got it to me.
Tahj, did you have any, did you watch the game last year when Jonah hit the shot?
I didn't. Well, I saw the shot, obviously, that was, being played all the time, but I never watched the whole game. But it's definitely funny to see, we both have the same number, and me and Jonah actually had a relationship, before I even came to USC. So, just funny how those things go full circle.
Yeah, that was my question. So, Jonah.
Yeah, me and Jonah cool, yep.
Did he fire you a text or something afterwards? I mean, I saw his comments on social media.
Yeah, right. As soon as we were in the locker room, he was the first one on the phone.
What was your phone like, man? Your phone must have been crazy.
Yeah. It was definitely, all over, national, syndications, things like that. I did the longest media day I ever had. I was waiting after the game for about an hour and a half. It was a unique situation.
Not bad, Jordan. Just come right in for a year, step in, and then go down in the history books of USC as a Bruin killer. Way to go, Tahj. We talked about it with Coach a little bit, Tahj. You guys had that tough streak of two games there at the end of the season that hurt. Then you guys found a way to bounce back. What got you guys going again, and how did you get the momentum swinging in the right direction for this last couple of games?
Yeah, I think that road trip with Colorado and Utah, I think it's always just a tough road situation, just the altitude and being in those environments, definitely difficult. But I think just kind of just watching film after those two games and just figuring out where we could be successful just in terms of our pace, our defensive intensity, things like that. But I think just coming back to, the SoCal, being back, in this good weather, I think it definitely lifted our spirits for sure.
You're listening to Tahj Eaddy on Trojans Live, USC's second leading scorer this season. Of course, the grad transfer from Santa Clara, and actually going on right now, Tahj, is the West Coast Conference Tournament, which you're very familiar with. That's kind of a rigged tournament, just the way they do the format. Gonzaga and typically St. Mary's or BYU, whoever the best teams, they go right into the semifinals. So you get a more of a crapshoot conference tournament this week. Three games and three nights, all difficult if you want to get it done. What do you think is going to be the key, going through this sort of gauntlet where, as Sean mentioned, you may see Utah and Colorado, two teams you lost to, just about a week ago, right out of the chute. What do you think is the key, for this team putting it together in Vegas?
Right. I think it really comes down to just our mental preparation, our mental toughness. I feel that we're the most talented team in this conference, one of the most talented teams in the country. So when we're, locked in and we're all on the same page and we're locked in defensively, I feel, we have a great chance of beating anybody.
Tahj, we talked a little about your basketball journey. There's been, some stops on your journey in different ways of you figuring out your game as it's gone along. What have you learned during this grad transfer year, and how did you end up choosing USC?
Well, just my whole situation, my whole basketball career, I've kind of been a little bit of a nomad. I've been all over. After high school, I've been in so many states.
A mercenary, man. That's what I used to call myself. Yeah. I was a mercenary. Hire me up and I'll come. We'll get some W's.
Right. Exactly. So when it came down to choosing USC, once I hit the transfers list, they were one of the first schools that kind of reach out to me. And it kind of just fit. I saw the roster. I understood that USC, they were limited on guards this upcoming season. I knew I had the opportunity to come in and play a significant role, which I was that was kind of my main thing. I wanted to go into a situation where I could lead and I could really be a part of something special. And I knew the talent USC had returning, as well as, you know, obviously Evan coming in. I just knew that, you know, we had opportunity to really do something special here. And the coaches kind of instilled that kind of mindset in me, whereas that, you know, we could really, you know, change the culture and really do something special. So that's what I was looking forward to. This is my first year playing in March Madness. So, you know, I'm just thankful for this opportunity for sure.
Yeah, has it surpassed even your plan, which you just laid out, your dreams? I mean, has it even surpassed it? Because we were just talking with Coach, you certainly surpassed our expectations for you.
Well, I always knew what I was capable of. I knew I just needed just the right situation. That's really what it comes down to a lot of times. You know, there's a lot of talented players all over the country. But it really depends on the situation you're in, whether you're put in a certain role where you can really succeed and things like that. And I've been fortunate we're at USC from day one. They've allowed me to be myself. But exceeding my expectations, I don't know. I don't think I would go that far.
Tahj, I've gotten a chance this year to talk to some football guys about the difficulties of, you know, the COVID protocols and being in the whole, you know, pandemic and the challenges that presents. What have been some of the difficulties for the basketball team and you yourself during this these tough times?
I would say just building our chemistry on and off the court. Like our summer this past summer, you know, we didn't have a typical summer as most college programs have had. We didn't meet until, you know, fall classes started, which was, you know, late August, early September. So, you know, we kind of got a late start with that, you know, to kind of build that chemistry because all that stuff matters. You know, each year, essentially, you have a whole new team. So, you know, to be able to get those reps in, it really matters. And then off the court, you know, that's where, you know, you guys really bond. You know, you go to little parties, little things like that where you can really, you know, build those kind of relationships. So it's been unique in that manner, but every single individual on this team is, you know, really close knit. You know, this is my first year where it's like, you know, it's not really too many arguments, no altercations, things like that. So, you know, we've been fortunate, you know, in that manner where it's kind of helped the process, but it's been an adjustment in terms of the chemistry for sure.
Last year's team got to go to Europe during the summer. So you really got the shaft on this one. Last one, you know, this is technically a free year. You have one more year of eligibility. Have they started recruiting you yet?
I wouldn't necessarily say recruiting, but, you know, kind of everything is in play. I'm kind of just playing it by ear. I'm really just looking forward to being able to play, you know, deep in the postseason because I think, you know, the team that we have, we can really do something special. So I'm really just excited about that.
Let's get some nets.
Sure. Every single USC fan is going to want to recruit you if you open it up and get you back for one more year and see you in the Galen Center, because that's the one thing this year has been missing. You guys have played like it's a sellout crowd every night, but maybe next year you'll actually get those fans back. That's Tahj Eaddy. He is certainly the hero, the Bruin killer, and he takes the Trojans into Vegas this week.